going to set up a hypothetical scenario, an unreal situation. If I were to lay out two cards and I asked you to mentally select one of those two cards, it would be interesting if I could say you're thinking of the Eight of Hearts, right? Now, a lot of people would say, big deal, 50-50 odds, you could guess and be right half the time. However, if I lay more cards out, the odds increase against me, right? Making this more difficult to achieve, or a few more, or even a few more. I'm going to turn my back. I want you to mentally select any one of those cards. Don't tell anyone what it is. Don't point to it. Change your mind as many times as you like, as long as you're going to arrive on a card that you're going to think of more so than the others. Have you got one in mind?
Yes.
Great. All right. Concentrate on your card. I'm going to go through the deck. I want you to look for your card, all right? I'm going to go through them. I want you to keep a poker face. I'm going to try to pick up on psychic vibrations.
What?
What are you
saying?
Have you seen your card yet? We may be getting close. Have you seen it yet? Well, that leaves about half the deck. This is sort of where the fun begins, all right? Give the deck one cut. Great. Right. Put both of your hands flat out like that. Without me influencing your choice, hand me one of the packets, but keep the other one for yourself. This has been a mental experiment. I believe it's been quite successful. For the first time, what was the card you merely thought of?
Queen of Diamonds.
Now, I don't know if you realize this or not, but I did influence your choice. When I said, hand me one of the packets, I emphasized that slightly more than keep the other one for yourself. It might be interesting if we took a look at the bottom packet of the card that you handed me, the Queen.
Wow.
Okay. Are we ready to start the show?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to start off by taking the four aces out of the deck. We're going to do this to a little bit of music. We're going to have a little bit of fun. How's everyone doing tonight?
Good.
Excellent. By the way, for those of you who just got here, this is Christopher. If you'd like a cocktail, just sort of raise your hand and he'll... Actually, all you have to do is think of the drink you want and he will serve it to you. It's really pretty amazing. Not really. Put him on the spot like that. How about a little card manipulating music? Maestro, please. Oh, yeah.
Somewhere beyond the sea, somewhere waiting for me. My lover stands on golden sands and watches the ships that go sailing somewhere beyond the sea. She's there watching for me. If I could fly like birds on high, then straight to her arms I'll go sailing. It's far beyond the stars, it's near beyond the moon. I know beyond the doubt, my heart will lead me there soon. Beyond the shore, we'll kiss just like before. Heaven will be beyond the sea, and never again I'll go sailing. Thank you.
Would you mind helping out? Put your hand flat out like that. Can everyone see his hand okay? We're going to put the ace of spades on your hand. The ace of clubs on your hand. Now, who is watching closely? Watch.
I'll never again. I'll go sailing.
No more sailing.
So long sailing, yeah, sailing.
No more sailing.
Goodbye, farewell, my friend.
No more sailing.
So long.
Farewell. All right, now that we got your attention, I'm going to show you guys what I like to call the fastest card trick in the world. You don't even have to take a card out of the deck, sir. I'm going to go like this. All you got to do is say stop. Wherever you say stop, I stop, you look, that's going to be your card, okay? Just say stop. Now, did I go too far or stop too soon? Did you see one? That was quick. Do you know how fast it's going to take me to find the four of spades? Seriously? Really? Check this out. The four of spades. Now, this is a very magic card. Look, if I put the four on the bottom, it jumps to the top. I'll do that again. Look, here, I'm going to put the four in the center of the deck. Would you agree that's about the center of the deck?
Yeah.
It jumps to the top. One last time. This time I'm going to leave it face up in the deck. So you can even, so would you all agree that that's face up in the center of the deck?
Yes.
You're staring right down on it. Don't look away. Don't even blink. Right under your nose from the middle to the top. I can't do it any better than that. Now a lot of people stop me and they say, what? How many four of spades you got in that deck? But I assure you, there's only one four of spades in the entire pack. Get as close as you want. Check it out. Have you guys ever seen magic coins before?
Yes.
I have some magic coins. These are indeed magic coins. You can look at them if you want to touch them, feel them. These are old silver dollars. They fooled hundreds and thousands of people. And if you're not careful tonight, right here and now, they're going to fool you too. What I'm about to demonstrate is taking years of practice and self-denial. Literally hours of celibacy. Which I didn't say was worth it. How about a little bit of coin manipulating music? Maestro, please. Should we try four?
Yeah.
Evidence of a misspent youth. Five coins, one hand. I'm not going to do anything. I just have five coins. This silver dollar is going to disappear right before your very eyes by getting smaller and smaller and smaller until you can't even see it anymore. It almost looks like it's getting smaller, doesn't it? As I get further away? It really does. Watch what happens. If I give the coin a squeeze, it disappears. It doesn't go too far. If I give it another squeeze, it comes back. Now, most people's money falls down, am I right?
Yes.
But my money doesn't fall down, my money falls up. Have you ever seen a coin fall up before, sir? Have you ever done any acid? No. Me neither. Focus your attention on this silver dollar as it defies the natural laws of gravity by falling.